Hi, welcome to Sips and Tips Advice. I'm Karen, and today I'm going to be doing another inspired look for you. And if you've watched my other inspired looks, you kind of just get the idea that for me, it's actually easier for me to just look at someone else and what they've done so I can do something different. You know, I think too many times we get stuck in doing the same thing over and over and over. And sometimes we need to stop looking at what we're doing and be like, hey, what's that other person doing? I want to see. And you never know what you'll be inspired to do because of someone else. It's not about copying, but we're all copies of each other. Let's think about it. It's like we're clones, but we're all our own individually stamped copies. So I think people need to stop being so concerned about that. When you put something out there, realize that people are going to be inspired by you. We're all going to be inspired by each other. At some point, you were inspired by someone. So anyway, I just want to put that out there. So on that note, I'm going to start with this. I was like, yo, if this ain't the most dramatic look, if you know on my page, you know there's no look that looks like this, point blank period, on my whole entire channel. So I'm like, yo, this is so bold, it's so full of life. And I followed her. Well, it's three of them total, but they're on YouTube. They go by Batalash, B-A-T-A, Lash, or you can go to their website, batalashbeauty.com. I was looking on how to work with Flash Cosmetics, and yo, this girl spanked this thing, and she's hilarious. So I totally enjoy watching her, and so I just Googled this look, and this came up, and I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna let go, try something different, be free, just go for it. So anyway, so that's what I'm doing today. I'm doing something different, and I hope this will inspire you to also step outside of your boundaries, outside of your comfort zone, and do something different. Don't worry about who's watching. Don't worry about who's gonna say, oh, you're trying to be like X, Y, Z. No, be you. Okay? Let's go for this.
All right, so I've already done my eyebrows, and here I'm just prepping my eyelids to start applying eyeshadow with Wet n Wild eye primer. And I'm also applying Milani Eye Shadow Eyes, and it's an espresso line that's 08. And I'm using that to create this smoky look. It's like a really, really deep burgundy look. And I prefer to use the brush because I don't feel like it gets exactly where I want it when I use the stick directly on my eye. So, personal preference. So now here I'm just buffing out all the hard lines, so when I'm applying the eyeshadow, you don't see those hard lines underneath, and I'm trying to blend through and hide it. Alright, so we're going to start with the first eyeshadow, and this is from Sonia Kassig's All Matte Palette. You can find that at Target. And I'm just using this to just put all over the base of my eye, so it makes it easier to run other colors through. Then I'm going with this Wet n Wild color from their Vanity Palette. It's just a matte nude shade, a little bit darker. Now I'm going in with magenta. This is from Coastal Scents. And I'm using this to create my transitional look. And this is, doing all the other colors before, it makes it a lot easier when you blend this color on so it doesn't end up choppy looking. There's nothing like a choppy looking crease. And now I'm just blending that edge back with the first brush I used with the same colors that was on it. Nothing additional. Like I said, I'm just blending the edges out here with that same magenta color from Coastal Scents. And the trick to this look was to keep blending. I cannot overstate that. There was a lot of blending in this. So first brush that I was using with the lighter new transitional colors. Now this is a color from NYX. It is called Electro Shock. And I got this from Ulta. I'm just using a pencil brush to pat this all over my eyelid. I'm patting it on, not blending it or brushing it over. And the cool thing about this blue color was when I added that Milani under base, it actually made it a really deep navy blue color. So here I'm just blending in the edges of this with the same brush I used to apply the magenta. Just want everything to blend in together seamlessly. That's why it's important to blend out the edge of your that base color first. And then this is a teal color. It's called Dare. That's also an NYX shade, and I'm mixing that with the Electro Shock so it blends seamlessly. There's no hard lines in between. All right. And then now I'm just taking some facial lotion. It's Pond's. You can use any. And I'm wiping off the fallout from the eyeshadow so I can apply my foundation. I've already moisturized my face and applied aloe. So here I just mixed the two tones, Ivory and Toast from Revlon Colorstay. And basically I matched it to my chest this time, which we all should be doing, matching our foundation to our chest so our face doesn't look, you know, super dark, you know. Anyway, blending in with this e.l.f. brush. There you go. Sorry to say I skipped a part to stop recording. So anyway, that was the RCMA colorless powder, setting powder that I just put over my face after setting my under eyes with Milani Frisco. And here I'm using this Milani shadow eyes again, so it'll make it easy for the eyeshadow to adhere to it. I blended it out, and now I'm adding that Wet n Wild color, blended that in. Now I'm adding this magenta color and blending that in so everything can start coming together. Okay, same magenta color. Now I'm going in with the Electro Shock and joining everything together. Bringing it down on the outside and bringing it down. And I'm just blending with this pencil brush. Blending. Same magenta color. Using that to fade out the edges. Like I said, there's a lot of blending going on here for this look to really get it where you want it. Now, I really wanted the colors to stick a little bit more on the bottom. So I applied some Wet n Wild. Now I'm going back in with that Electric Shock Blue for NYX. And applying that all at the bottom, and that really did the trick. Blending that in with a pencil brush so everything looks nice and smoky. Now I'm using this black color from Yabby eyeshadow, and I'm just applying it on the corners of my eye. There you go. Yeah, applying it just to the corners just to darken it up, because I'm not going to use any eyeliner for this look. Then I'm blending some more magenta to really make sure the eyeshadow looks like that. Now I'm adding Sin from NYX as well, and I'm using that to place in the inner corner, and then I'm gonna blend it into the eyeshadow to make it all look seamless. Now I'm curling my eyeshadow, applying mascara both on the top and bottom, and then I'm going to add lashes. And this is the 574. I got that from the beauty store. So anyway, moving on, I'm contouring my face with Caramel from Ben Nye, just to add a nice little tanned look to my face. Just basically contouring. Same caramel color, nothing changed. I'm gonna contour my nose. Just using a smaller brush. And then I'm gonna go back over everything with Milani Frisco pressed powder foundation. Just to tone down the whole look and smooth it out so everything looks nice and seamless. All right, and that's the same Milani. I'm just going over everything with a bigger brush to make life easier. Going back in with Caramel underneath my neck to make sure I contour that as well. Can't leave the neck out. All right, now I'm adding this blush. It is Shimmer Mocha from LA Girls Cosmetics. And now I'm adding Becca Highlight onto my Cupid's bow, tip my nose, and high points my cheek. And now I'm adding this NYX lip liner in soft brown all over my lips. And now I'm adding two colors together. As you can see, one is a Milani matte color and the other one is just a satin soft finish. And then I'm adding some lip gloss over it from NYC, and that's it. I hope you like the look, and thank you for watching. I'll talk to you soon. Bye, love.